stands in our way is our broken political system that's deliberately being undermined by our president to continue to abuse the power of the office. Donald Trump is the only president who's decided not to represent the whole country. The president has his base. We need a president who works for all Americans.
Well, as you can see, Joe Biden's in, tearing into President Trump at that rally in Pittsburgh. Biden making his appeal to middle-class voters and unions. Other candidates trying to stand out from the crowded Democratic field, of which there are many. Here's one of them, 2020 Democratic presidential candidate Andrew Yang. Nice to see you in person.
It's great to see you as well.
Officially meeting for the first time. Biden did not really go after you or any of his Democratic challengers. What do you think of that?
Well, Joe Biden has an advantage of having sky-high name recognition. He's been in the public space for a long time. And so he's focused on Donald Trump. And I agree with the fact that we have to solve the problems that got Donald Trump elected in 2016. And that's what Democrats should be focused on.
I wonder if you were insulted by the sleight of hand there, or the sleight of lack of acknowledgement in Pittsburgh, you and the others.
Not at all. I mean, he was a sitting vice president for 8 years. He's leading in the polls. If I were him, I would have done the exact same thing.
Okay, interesting. You want to do universal basic income, and to prove it, you want to give people in Iowa $1,000 a day.
Oh, it's $1,000 a month.
I
couldn't afford $1,000.
$12,000 a year, I should say. I correct myself. Well, are you pandering to the folks in Iowa to try and get that attention?
Well, we've already done this in New Hampshire. And what's fun about this is that when people actually get $1,000 a month, you see they do very positive, productive things. The family in New Hampshire is paying their daughter's college tuition bill. The same thing's going to happen in Iowa. So there are all of these abstract fears about people getting $1,000 a month when in real life, if Americans got $1,000,
what do you think that does? What changes for people if you do that?
Well,
because some would see it as just a simple handout, as you know.
You know, what's phenomenal is there's a lot of data on this. And what happens is that people's mental health improves, stress goes down, relationships improve, their physical health even improves over time, their trust in community members and their society goes up. So there are a lot of phenomenal effects, and we're already seeing this even on a very, very small scale with the family in New Hampshire that have been doing this for since January 1.
I'd be interested to see how people in Iowa respond to that, as you mentioned, New Hampshire there. How do you beat this administration when you're growing at 3.2%? That was the GDP number for the first quarter this year.
Well, GDP is a highly flawed indicator of how we're doing. I mean, GDP is at a record high. Meanwhile, our life expectancy has declined for 3 straight years because of an increase in drug overdoses and suicides. So if you ask the average American which you care more about, your neighbor's life expectancy or this phantom GDP number, and Donald Trump made the same case when he was running for office.
I don't know if you can make the case that it's phantom. I mean, it moves markets quite literally. Another question here. You support the Green New Deal, correct? You support Medicare for All. There's a hearing on that today in the House we're waiting for. You support a carbon tax. You support free or drastically reduced tuition at community colleges. Who would you, and we got a big list of all the candidates so far, who do you believe is the most liberal or the most progressive in this field today?
It's a fun question. I mean, it's a big field. You know, it's like, for me, the liberal and conservative, it's not left, it's not right, it's forward. We have to start solving the problems of the American people, and we have to know that one of the main things, or several of the main things that are driving Americans to record levels of stress are our sky-high education costs and our sky-high health care costs, the leading cause of bankruptcy. So we have to come together, and the congressperson who was just talking about it, he said correctly that the costs in our health care system are out of control and we need to bring them down.
I didn't get a name from you, by the way, on that question.
Oh, you noticed that, huh?
Andrew Yang, it's $1,000 a month, okay?
It is that.
Thank you very much for your time. We'll see where it goes. Medicare for All hearing coming up in minutes. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Phil.
All right.